they meet again for the last time.
Hey, give that back right now.
Dad, Nicholas and Michelle are fighting over the lightsaber again.
You don't even know how to use it.
The student had become the master.
Dad!
I'm warning you, if you don't give me my lightsaber back, there will be consequences.
If you strike me down, I will return twice as strong.
Dad, better get up there before... Too late.
Kaylin, were you calling me? What's going on?
He hit me, did ya?
I'm coming, Michelle. Our family watches way too much Star Wars.
Nicholas? Nicholas, come down here right now.
Yes, Father?
Aren't you a little short for a stormtrooper?
Huh?
Oh, never mind. Did you just hit your sister?
I did what any Jedi would do under the circumstances.
Oh, really? I don't remember Luke Skywalker ever hitting Princess Leia.
He would if she took his lightsaber.
Again? Nicholas, we've been over this before. You've no right to hit your sister.
But this time I warned her before I hit her.
That doesn't make it right. Go apologize now.
No.
Excuse me?
I was crushing our rebellion.
Go apologize.
Protecting an empire.
Look, I am your father.
No! It's my lightsaber. Why don't you make her apologize?
I will. It's just that right now, right now you're in a timeout. Go sit down over there.
Oh, this is so unfair. She's the one who stole something. Why am I the one in trouble?
Anger leads to the dark side, Nicholas. This has to stop.
I agree. It's just that...
That lightsaber.
Yeah.
Well, maybe you could use one of your Jedi mind tricks. You know, like, you will obey your parents.
Yeah. That easy, huh?
Well, in any case, someone's got to talk to him, and it's not going to be me. I'll go upstairs, talk to Michelle, get the girls ready for bed, but then I've got to get ready for tomorrow. Think you can handle the Darth Grinch?
Sure. Well... Actually, I'm not sure what to say. You know, he thinks he's defending a just cause. Michelle was wrong to take his lightsaber.
Yeah, but you know, there is a goodness that goes beyond the ethics of Star Wars.
Exactly. So how do we get him to understand that? How do we get him to be excited about giving up something good for a greater good thing? You know, this wouldn't happen so much if he would just share the lightsaber once in a while. Anyway, I'll try my best.
Do or do not. There is no try.
Caitlin's right. Our family watches way too much Star Wars.
Your Jedi mind tricks do not work on me.
How did you know? Oh, never mind. Hey, Nicholas, we gotta talk.
Dad, it's not fair. You and Mom always say that we have to fight for what's right, but whenever I do, I get in trouble. It just doesn't make sense.
I know it doesn't make sense. I'm trying to think of a way to explain it to you. See, Nicholas. Have I ever told you the story about Christmas stockings?
Christmas stockings? They're too... Who cares about Christmas stockings? They're too small for anything really fun to fit into. They're just an excuse for Mom to give us lame stuff like toothbrushes and socks. Everyone knows that all the good presents go under the Christmas tree. Like a pod racer? Are you getting me a pod racer for Christmas?
No.
Why do we have Christmas stockings anyway?
Well, actually... The story behind Christmas stockings revolves around a young boy a lot like you. And he got pretty fired up when someone was doing something they were not supposed to.
What was his name?
Nicholas.
Good name.
Yeah, I thought you might like that.
Was he a Jedi?
No, actually he was a bishop.
What's that?
It's kind of like a pastor.
Well, did he have a lightsaber?
No, but he did once deck a guy who was telling lies about Jesus.
Okay, I like him. You can tell me about Christmas stockings.
Okay. Well, this story actually starts long before Nicholas was a bishop. He was just a young boy, a lot like you. About 12 years old.
Yeah. Hey, Julian the farmer, my favorite customer. How are you on this fine day, eh?
Hello, Sebellius. You're in such a good mood for so early in the morning.
Hey, and why not? It is market day, after all. Don't you just love market days? Ah, smells like money.
It smells like fish.
Hey, you lack imagination, my friend. Fish mean the sea. The sea mean ships. Ships mean cargo. Cargo mean many travelers coming to our fair village ready to part with their money. Yeah. You there, young man, you look like someone who knows the value of a good pot. See here, the finest cookery in all of... it's you, Nicholas.
Good morning to you too, Sebellius. Julian?
Nothing personal, you understand. You're a fine young man. But a man's got to make a profit, eh? And for such a rich youth, you know, you never actually buy anything. Why do you bother coming down here anyway?
I like the docks. Seeing so many groups of people together from different places, walks of life. Some aware of God's love for them. Some of them aren't. Makes me feel alive.
Hey, you're an odd one. Come back when you're willing to part with some of that inheritance of yours. But for now, you're blocking the cart from the paying customers. Hey.
Would you like some help, Julian?
Yeah, Nicholas, that'd be great.
Ah, the daughters of Marcus, my favorite customers. Come and see what I have in store for you. Jewels of such rare and exquisite quality.
Not today, thank you. Come along, Helen.
Bye.
It's too expensive.
Some perfume, perhaps.
Oh, Helen.
Helen.
I have ribbons.
Ribbons,
straight from Persia. Guaranteed to attract the attention of any young man when adorned on such a pretty lady as yourself.
It's true. I'm rather beautiful.
Helen, we need vegetables, not hair accessories.
You and your vegetables. How am I ever going to get Felix to notice me without a pretty new ribbon for my hair?
Perhaps you could accessorize with broccoli.
Very funny.
You can ask Father for the money if you want, but I doubt you'll get it.
Oh, why do we have to be so poor? Especially when I'm so pretty. It's such a waste.
Here, Lucia. This is the money that Father gave me for the vegetables, but there's not much, so see if you can get, I don't know, some farmer to give us a fair price.
I'm not going to take advantage of my friendship with Julian just to get a deal on potatoes.
I think Constance is right. Batting an eye, flipping some hair, it might be the difference between a nice thick soup and the Brussels sprouts we had all last week.
Helen.
What? I'm just saying, having to eat fish every day is bad enough. But fish and Brussels sprouts, it's just wrong.
Good morning, Julian.
Thanks, Nick. Hi, Lucia. You look great today.
Thank you. Father wanted me to tell you that you're welcome to join us for dinner tonight, if you would like.
Yeah, that'd be great. Tell him I'd be honored.
I will.
Okay, see you then.
Okay. Oh, I forgot. We need vegetables.
Oh, here. Take all this, free of charge. Don't worry about it.
No. I couldn't. I'll pay for them. Or some of them.
Really. Don't worry about it. I'm just trying to turn a gift in return for your family's hospitality. It's good manners.
Well, in that case, we'll split the difference.
All right.
Handsome today.
Helen, my sweet little kumquat. So beautiful, with a face just like the angel. Wouldn't you agree? Yes, I knew you would. What is it you want now, Helen?
Nothing. Just a new hair ribbon.
Well, no.
Please, Sebellius has ribbon straight from Persia. I'm sure I would just die if I had ribbon straight from Persia.
Well, it's a good thing you're not getting one then. Here, see what you can sell today. I'll see you later at home tonight.
Hey, Marcus, my favorite customer. What can I do for you today?
Oh, nothing for me today, thank you. I just came to give you this.
Hey, how thoughtful, hey. To what do I owe the honor?
Oh, as a big thank you for allowing me to invest in a share of your cargo. Any word on the ship yet?
Yes, one of my finest. Due in port any day now, hey.
Well, that's wonderful news. Wonderful. Please, forgive my anxiety, but I'm counting on using the profits from the ship to, as a dowry for my daughter.
Hey, yes, for your little Lucia, is that right? She and that young farmer have been in love for quite some time, eh?
Yes, Lucia, my little sweet potato. Oh, so beautiful, with a face just like the angel. Wouldn't you agree?
Hey,
oh, I knew you would.
Hey.
You know, it's taken me a long time to save enough money for her to use as a dowry for her to get married. Hey. And I have two others to think of. I'll have to have money enough for them as well.
Hey, don't worry, my
that's
friend.
Why I am so grateful for this opportunity to increase in my funds.
Hey, yes. No worries, my friend. When that ship comes in, you'll have money enough for all three girls to marry at once, eh?
Hey, Sebellius, don't deprive me of all of my daughters just yet. You know, it's hard to think of parting with just the one.
Hmm. What is this? The other two are not spoken for, huh? No young men on the horizon, huh?
Oh, let's see. No, not so worthy, no. How about that one, no?
No.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Hey!
You are way too bold. Look at yourself. How do you expect yourself to marry a decent husband acting like that?
I don't want a decent husband. I want Felix.
You know, for someone who doesn't like fish, you'd think you'll settle for someone other than a fisherman.
I just can't help it. He's just so in need of a makeover. I mean, those sandals. What was he thinking? And that tunic? It's just so 290s. He's like a desperate cry for help. I know I could save him if only he'd let me.
Good morning, Felix.
Morning, Julian. Morning, Nicholas. Got any Brussels sprouts today?
I must have left them in the wagon.
I'll get them for you.
Thanks, Nicholas. What's the matter? Bad catch day?
No. I just hate market days.
Why's that?
It's the worst day for a fisherman. The dock's overcrowded. You got these clueless inlanders like they own the place.
Alexander?
Julian?
Whoa, you know this guy?
Yeah. This is Alexander. He's a brother from Sparta. You know his father, Justin the Taylor? He comes here regularly. We haven't seen you around for a while, though.
Yeah, I've been busy. Father's had me working at home in the trade the past few years. But he thinks I'm ready now. Made this myself.
Nice.
Yeah.
In fact, he thinks I'm so good, he's just sent me on my first tour. Learning the trade from other tailors, collecting fabrics from different cities. This is my last stop before coming home.
Well, I suppose the inlander will have to travel to see the world. In a port town, the world comes to you.
Oh, but you wouldn't believe what you learn from visiting other places. I met these guys in Antioch, real learned scholars. They were explaining to me how Jesus didn't have a soul like we do.
He didn't?
No, you see, when God created Jesus...
created Jesus?
He replaced his soul with the Word.
So you're saying Jesus wasn't fully God or fully man?
Exactly. But then how could he be one with the Father? Through a unity of will. You see, Jesus only receives the name Son of God because God chooses to call him that. But Jesus himself is not eternal like the Father, because there was a time when he was not. Real deep stuff. I wish I could have stayed there longer, but...
Heresy! I can't mean you. You're suffering my wrath.
You two go on. I'll guard the fish.
Let me go! I have to smite him!
Smite me?
Let me at him, I say. Let me at him. Must smite heretic!
Heretic?
You're going down!
Nicholas, calm down. Alexander is a friend of mine. I'm sure he didn't mean anything.
Mean anything? Do you have any idea what he was saying?
Whoa! Not exactly, but it sounded about right, didn't it?
I guess.
That's it. Taking you all on.
Just how are you going to do that?
With the greatest weapon of all time. Hang on a sec.
What is that thing? Behold!
It's just a scroll.
Oh. I knew that.
From the writings of John, a disciple of Jesus Christ, and not some idiot from Antioch. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God at the beginning. All things were created through him, and apart from him, not one thing was created that has been created. Life was in him, and that life was the light of men.
What's that all about?
Appears to be an argument over a theological matter, mistress.
Oh, Christians nowadays, they are so annoying. Remember the good old days when the empire was contained to fit them to the lion? I myself was far too young. I can remember them, but still, I'm certain it was a much simpler time. Oh.
To be sure, mistress.
Lady Perpetua, eh? My favorite customer.
You say that to all your customers?
Ah, but with you, I mean it. And how is my favorite customer on this fine day?
Ah, oh, Salibus, I'm unwell.
Oh, so sorry to hear it, eh?
My dear artisan simply refused to let us have more than one slave in the house. And we have to borrow poor Fronto here, which is nothing short of embarrassing. No offense, Fronto.
None taken, mistress.
You know how hard it's for me to be unseen in the public place without my own slave girl?
An impossible burden, I'm sure. Yeah. How can I help?
I need something new or pretty, or I shall be entirely put out.
I have just the thing.
Ooh.
This is the one whom I said, the one coming after me has surpassed me, because he existed before me. No one has ever seen God, the one and only Son. The one who is at the Father's side. He has revealed him. As Christians, we have to understand that Jesus existed from the very beginning as God, with God. If he didn't, if he wasn't fully God and fully man, then he could not have made up the difference between us and the Father. His sacrifice would not have been complete, and we would still be left in our sin. Besides, how else can we truly understand what Jesus gave up for us? He was at the Father's side. Man, the Father's side in heaven with all glory, all honor, and all praise. In perfect unity and love. And he left that to be born a man in a stable. Can you even imagine that kind of sacrifice? The lies you're telling, it just cheapens that. Makes me so mad. I could just punch someone.
Okay, I'm sorry. I was wrong. I recant or whatever.
All right. I forgive you. Just watch what you say about Jesus, will you? The Christ Mass is coming up, and I don't want to make Father Clement's job any harder by confusing his parishioners.
I'm sorry. Really, man, I had no idea I was saying something heretical. No hard feelings?
Nah. Jesus forgave me, So I guess I have to forgive you too.
You're very passionate when it comes to theology, aren't you?
My parents taught me. They used to be big on sacred writings.
They aren't anymore?
Nicholas is an orphan.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Plague. A couple years back. I'm all right, though. Left me with a good inheritance. My parents were rich, as well as pious. Besides, I know how to take care of myself.
I can see that.
Dang it. Hi, Felix.
Oh, hi, Helen.
Did you have a good catch today?
I did all right.
I bet you did more than all right, strong guy like yourself. I bet you were able to haul in all kinds of fish.
Well, I haven't met a fish that can escape these bad boys.
I'll bet, and I'm sure it'll be a great comfort for your future wife, I mean, to know that she has such a strong husband around to provide for her.
I forgot something over by the... left my fishing net. The rocks were... Julian.
Hey, you forgot your net. He'll be back.
Come on, Helen. Let's go look at something shiny.
I see not much has changed since the last time I was here.
Yeah. Felix is still trying to catch fish, and Helen's still trying to catch Felix.
That reminds me. How's your betrothal to Lucia going? My mother is wondering when we begin an invitation to the wedding.
That is... we're not exactly...
Don't tell me you haven't spoken to your father yet. I mean, you've been in love with her since you're like 5 years old. Your family's approve of the match, don't they?
Of course. We're just waiting for the dowry to make it official. But I don't mind waiting. Lucia's worth it.
You're a lucky man, Julian. In all my travels, I have yet to meet a woman worthy of my affection.
Oh, please.
No. It's not because I'm conceited. Or, well, rather it kind of is. You see, I can be a bit big-headed at times, and Mother won't approve of a match unless she thinks I'm marrying someone who can knock me down a peg or two.
That sounds like Lucia's other sister.
Constance?
Yeah, she doesn't take flack from anyone, and also, she's really nice.
Yeah, I'm sure she's great, but from what I remember about her, it wouldn't work out.
Why not?
Well, she's not exactly my type. No offense to your future sister-in-law, but I want someone who looks more like, well, who looks like, whoa, who looks like that? Who is she?
Who, that?
Yeah, her, right there.
That's Lucia's other sister, Constance.
No.
Yeah.
The skinny one with freckles?
She grew up.
Yeah, she did.
You used to call her the homely one, if I'm not mistaken.
No, did I? I don't remember that. You think she remembers that?
One way to find out. Go talk to her, unless you're scared.
Please, guys, I got this. Excuse me, miss. Do you happen to have some papyrus I can borrow? I'd like to write home to tell my mother I've just met the woman of my dreams.
Wow. Does that line work on the woman in Sparta? Because it sure isn't working here.
Oh! Wait. How did you know I was from Sparta?
You're Alexander, the tailor's son.
So you remember me, huh?
I remember you calling me the homely one. So what is it you want, Alexander of Sparta?
Once?
Yes. Why did you walk all this way, just to talk to me? Was it to apologize for calling me the homely one?
Dude, I thought you said she's supposed to be nice.
She is. You must be as bad as with women as you are with theology.
Well, would it make a difference?
What?
If I apologized.
Oh, you don't need to apologize. I forgave you a long time ago. Especially, it wouldn't be right of me since I used to call you frog face behind your back. Because
You looked like a frog.
Dude, he totally did. His eyes were just so big, and then sometimes his cheeks were just...
Well, do I look like a frog now?
No, you look nice. Do I look homely?
Not remotely. You're not like any girl I've ever met.
Wow, I thought your first line was bad.
You're not going to make this easy for me, are you?
No, not easy, but not impossible either.
Really?
No. Any godly man with a good character and reputation from a good family with talent and means enough to provide for a future one has a chance.
But that's exactly the kind of man I am.
Good. Then as a godly man with a good character and reputation, you'll be more than happy to know that you're more than welcome to continue this conversation with my father. Goodbye, Alexander of Sparta. It'll be interesting to see what kind of man you really are.
Smooth. Wouldn't you say so, Nicholas?
Oh, yeah. Very smooth.
I am in love.
What? What? That was very quick.
Hey, there's your sister, Helen, right? I wonder if she would know when a good time would be to.
Wait, you're not actually going to go talk to her father, are you?
Helen, wait up.
Okay.
Well,
okay then. I closed my shop a little early today, and well, I'm due at Marcus's myself, and I have a feeling I don't really want to be late. Hey, you want to wait around for Felix for me? He forgot his net, and I'm sure he'll come back soon.
No problem.
All right, thanks, Nick. You're a saint.
All that time spent abroad, who knew everything I ever wanted in a woman was waiting for me right here in Petara.
Oh, Alexander, I'm so happy. And don't worry, I'm sure Father will approve. You can come by the house tonight after supper to ask him.
Sorry, I forgot my net. Hey, what were those two talking about?
Oh, that. Alexander was wondering when it would be a good time to talk to Helen's father.
For what?
He's making a marriage proposal. I'll say one thing for that heretic. He doesn't waste any time. See you later, Felix.
Oh. A proposal. Well, this is good news. Good for him. No more Helen pestering me all the time. All that eye batting and hair flipping. Oh, Felix, you're so strong. Oh, Felix, help me carry this firewood. Oh, Felix, don't look pretty today. Oh, Felix, how my eyes sparkle. Felix! Oh, Felix. Oh, great.
Is everything okay with you?
Huh?
That's the third time you've checked the door tonight. Are you expecting someone?
Oh, you just never know. Someone could stop by.
If you're expecting Felix, forget it. He's never going to want to pursue you the way you chase after him all the time.
At least he knows how I feel about him. It's better than pretending I don't care.
I'm telling you, you're making it too easy.
And you make it too hard.
I'm just trying to weed out the boys from the men, like that boy at the market today.
Whoa, whoa. What boy at the market today?
You liked him! Admit it! I can tell by the way you've been complaining about him all day.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Excuse me. Who's this boy you're talking about? And should I be concerned?
Yes!
No! Father, if there was any real man with any real interest in me, you'd be the first to know.
Good to know. Good to know. Big relief.
Be careful what you wish for. Someday, someone is going to step up and jump through all those ridiculous hoops you've set up, and then you'll be in trouble. Why don't you go get the door this time, Constance?
Well, who is it?
It's Alexander, the tailor's son. From Sparta.
Well, are you going to ask him in or not? Oh, Alexander. Good to see you. Excuse me a minute. You know, I've been meaning to fix that, but I just haven't gotten around to it. Good to see you. You know, your father and I are old friends, and, you know, he speaks very highly of you. Last time we spoke, you were on your journeyman tour.
I've just come back, sir.
Ah, well then, what can I do for you?
I've come to ask your permission to marry your daughter, Constance.
Oh, Constance. My little sweet bitter melon. Oh. Look, so beautiful. With a face like an angel. Wouldn't you agree? Of course you would. Now, things are becoming quite clear now. Come, sit. Well, I must tell you, Alexander, I am quite impressed. Yes, I am quite impressed. You know, Constance doesn't make it easy on her suitors. In fact, you're the very first one to make it this far.
I'm not surprised. Wait, how many have there been?
You know, Alexander, I have great respect for your family. And to marry a tailor such as yourself would be a wonderful match for one of my daughters. I would like to see Constance situated well in life, but you have not known her very long. How do you know you are right for each other? And for that matter, how do you know your family would approve?
Well, for my family, that's easy. Constance is exactly the kind of woman my mother has always wanted for me. And whatever mother wants, father wants too, if he knows it's good for him. And for myself, please don't think that because I made up my mind quickly, I made it up lightly. It's like on my travels. The right fabric can either make or break a tailor. And you don't always know what you're looking for either until you find it. But once you do, you have to act quickly or you might miss out on something amazing. Constance is like a rare piece of silk hidden among rags.
Well, Constance, do you approve of this match?
That is... Yes?
Yes!
Well then, you have my blessing.
There is the matter of dowry, however. My family will not expect too much. I'm willing to wait however long.
Oh, dowry? That will not be a problem.
It won't?
No. Lucia, Constance, I have been saving this as a surprise, but I have invested in one of Sebellius's cargo ships, and it's due to arrive any day now. When it does, there will be money enough for both of you to marry as soon as you like, and enough for Helen, too, when her time comes.
Father?
Yes.
But can you bear to part with us all at the same time?
Oh, I have the best daughters. The very best.
Yes, I do have the very best daughters.
What about Helen?
Oh, Helen? Oh, don't have to worry about Helen. When you leave, at least I have her around.
Marcus!
Yes?
Can't allow that man to marry your daughter.
Felix, what are you doing here?
Quiet, Helen. The men are talking.
Felix!
For one thing, he's a heretic.
A guy picks up one little piece of heresy on his travels.
And he also strikes me as kind of conceited. And no offense, but your daughter is also kind of conceited. So I don't think that would make a very good match at all.
Conceited?
And he's all the way from Sparta. He's practically a foreigner.
It's a half a day's walk from here.
Are you telling me you're going to let some conceited foreign heretic marry your daughter? I don't think so.
Felix, I've never seen you like this.
What Helen needs is someone who can let her know that she's pretty without pampering her vanity. And you want her to marry a tailor's son? Can you imagine Helen surrounded by all those clothes? You might as well just add coal to the fire.
Helen, but...
Go on.
No. What Helen needs is someone that can help balance her out. Someone who is more interested in her good heart than her good looks.
I think Felix is right, Father.
That's what I'm... Yeah.
A tailor is the last person I should marry.
That's what I'm saying.
And to be so far away from home would be terrible.
Exactly.
I'd be better off married to a local man.
That's right.
Some humble, God-fearing fisherman, perhaps?
Oh, wait.
Someone who really knows me and can bring out the best in me?
Hi.
But, unfortunately, a girl can't choose who makes an offer of marriage for her. Maybe an arrogant heretic from a foreign land is the best I could hope for.
Okay, feeling a little judged over here.
Unless someone else would like to make an offer of marriage for me.
Marcus?
Yes, Felix?
I think you should let me marry Helen instead of Alexander.
Oh, so you do you?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Well, I approve.
Really?
Yes. You have my blessing as well.
Oh, good.
Oh, Felix!
Hey, not yet.
Oh, you guys would be perfect for each other. Yes, yeah, you too. It would be perfect.
Yeah, I don't know why I didn't think of that.
All right, young man. It's getting late and time to leave. Say your goodbyes now.
Good night, beautiful.
Good night, frog face.
Hey.
Hey. Good night, Alexander.
Good night, Julian.
Good night, Lucia.
Good night, Helen.
Good night, my love, Falafel. I'll miss you. Kisses. Good night. Mwah.
Love, Falafel. Did I just get engaged to Helen?
Yeah, it's been a strange day for me, too.
Oh, Helen, settle down. Don't get crazy on me now. I've had enough drama for one night. I'm tired. I'm going to bed. You too. Don't wait up too late.
We'll be right behind you. We just have to hang up our stockings for the night.
All righty.
Hey, girls. I'll do the washing tonight.
Phew! Helen, what do you do to make your feet smell so bad?
I don't know what you're talking about. My feet smell like roses.
If you say so.
Here, Constance, go smell this.
Oh, gosh. Helen, what do you do to make your feet smell so bad? Poor Felix when he finds out when he marries you.
Poor Alexander when he tastes your cooking.
Poor... Well, I guess there's nothing to feel bad about Julian for. She is the best cook.
And my feet don't smell. So yes, I think we'll be happy.
As long as he never hears you sing.
Hey!
Oh, Constance, you are so lucky to be marrying a tailor. Hey, do you think I could borrow some of your clothes?
So then, see, Nicholas, each daughter was engaged and married to the man she loved. Nicholas? Hey, Nicholas, are you paying attention?
Dad, I thought you said this was going to be a good story.
Hey, this is a good story. Come on.
No, it isn't. There are too many girls in it, and it's all about weddings and stuff. Are you sure you didn't mean to tell this story to Michelle? She is the one who stole my lightsaber.
Hey, I'm not done yet. Remember how I said each daughter had to have a dowry to get married?
Dad!
Come on, trust me. This will be good.
Okay, what's a dowry anyway?
Well, back then, a dowry was money that the bride's family gave the young couple to help them get started and to provide for them and any children they might have. It showed that the bride came from a hardworking and respectable family. Without it, she could not get married. So let me tell you what happens the next day.
Just for you, a special price. Hey, look, you're nice with your shirt. Hey, special price. Two shekels. Yes. It costs money. Oh, what is this? Hey, here you go. Thank you.
Hey, Sebellius!
Just what I need right now.
Sebellius! Over here, it's me, Marcus!
Marcus, my friend, hello, I didn't see you there. How are you?
Oh, Sebellius!
How are you, my friend?
Oh, as well as any proud father can be. Who's about to lose three daughters? Have you heard the news? All three of my girls are engaged to be married.
Yes, that's great news.
Hey, Sebellius, you must be some kind of prophet, eh? Predicting this would happen.
Listen, Marcus, I was just coming to find you. Eh?
Oh, you were? Oh, that must mean that the ship has finally arrived. Oh, my girls, they will be so thrilled. Now all three can get married. Now, I have to tell you, as a father, it's a hard place to be in. Just yesterday, I couldn't tell you if I would be happy to see the ship or not, but I'm glad it's here. It's time to celebrate. Let us dance.
Marcus, stop. Just stop. You're a terrible dancer. No, I mean the ship, the one that you invested in. I just got word.
Oh, what?
It seems it ran into a violent storm off the coast of Crete. It struck a rock coming into the harbor
Hey, wait a minute. What are you saying?
I'm saying the ship's not coming back.
But my investment, my cargo, surely that made it ashore and will be sold for profit?
No cargo, no profit. Some of the men made it to shore, but that's all.
You mean you lost my money?
Hey, you knew the risks when you entered into the venture.
But you told me there would be enough money for all of my daughters.
Hey, don't be so selfish, huh, Marcus? I lost money on this too. Do you have any idea how long it will take me to recover from this?
But Sebellius, you're a rich man. Look at you.
Hey.
Hey. You have other ships. But that money, that was all I had. Now, surely you can reimburse me what I gave you. At least I can have my money back, can't I?
Marcus, my friend, I am sorry for your loss. Truly I am, but that was not our arrangement. If I reimbursed every bad investment I ever made, how would I ever get ahead in life?
But my daughters, what will become of them now?
Hey, like I said, my friend.
Friend? No, you're no friend. You have ruined me.
Me? None of my ships ever sank before I took you on as an investor. Maybe it's you who has ruined me. Huh? I was doing you a favor. Maybe God is against you. Have you ever thought of this? I was doing you a favor, letting a fisherman have a share of my merchandise. I think you should show a little gratitude.
Gratitude?
Yes.
Gratitude? No, all I can think about now are my children.
I have children too. I need to think about their inheritance.
Docks, the same he's been doing every night since he found out about that ship.
He doesn't like to come home and thinks until he thinks we're asleep. I think he feels too guilty about what happened.
Poor father. It's not like any of us blame him.
I can't bear to see him like this. Do you think one of us should try to talk to him?
I'll do it. You two go to bed. I don't mind waiting.
It's late. Why are you still up?
Waiting for you. I've had some supper I've kept warm.
I can get it myself. Why don't you go to bed?
That's not fair. I worked hard on this meal. How am I supposed to know if it's any good if I can't see if you like it or not?
Oh, all right. It is good. Really, it is. Now, go to bed.
Father, I need to talk to you. Please? Will you just look at me?
No, I can't look at you or your sisters. How can I, knowing that I have failed you?
You didn't fail us. You had no way of knowing that the ship would sink.
No? No, I suppose not. How could I have known that would happen? Sebellius, he was right. This is God's doing. He has taken away all of my joy and has turned my very own daughters, my greatest blessings, into curses.
Father, don't say that. We have to trust that God has allowed this to happen for a reason.
Trust God? No, no. Trust me when I tell you that nothing good can come of this. Have you thought about what will happen to you girls now? I mean, truly thought about it. Because I have. How much longer before I am an old man, unable to provide for you any longer? You have no brothers to take care of you. And you know no decent man will want to marry you without a dowry. Do you know what happens to young women who have no inheritance? What kind of profession will be left to you when I am too old and feeble to provide for you any longer? I can think of one. Am I to live to see my very own girls? My beautiful girls?
Father, don't cry. God will show us a way out of this.
No, there is no way. We have nothing saved. All of our money is gone. And we have nothing worth selling.
That's not exactly true.
Pardon me, Mistress. There's a girl here from the village.
What's that to me?
She wants to speak with you. She's one of the daughters of that fish fellow you and your friends were talking about the other evening.
What fish fellow?
The one who lost all his money and now his daughters can't marry.
Oh, yes. That was quite a scandal. I wonder what she wants now. All right, Fronto, you must send her in. Oh, my poor child, how are you? Such terrible business, so sad. We were very sorry for you. I'm sure if I told my friend about it, we would just sit there and shaking our head, wishing there was something to be done.
I'm relieved to hear you say that. I believe there is something you can do.
Now? I hope you're not coming here asking for a hand now, my dear. Good girl like you with deals for begging. You can go straight back to the village.
I wouldn't have come empty-handed. I was hoping to sell you something.
What? Fish? Oh, charming. My dear, you hardly need to see me about that. Fronto here? Buy whatever we need on the market day. Still, maybe we could change the menu around this week.
No.
Excuse me?
It's not fish. I was hoping... I heard you talking the other day to Sebellius, the merchant, about...
Oh, yes. My own slave girl? I've been asking Augustine for weeks now. I bet I can get you cheap too, consider your circumstances. Oh, I'm sorry, my dear. I meant no offense.
None taken. I only asked enough for my sisters to marry.
Of course. Won't that just be a thing for everyone? Your sister can marry, I got my own slave girl, and I don't have to borrow Fronto here anymore. I hope you don't mind, Fronto.
I'll try to survive, Mistress.
That's perfect. But, oh, I just spent this month allowances on this silly necklace. Austin would be so grumpy if I asked something now. I tell you what, you come back at the end of the month. I will have the money then.
Thank you, Mistress. I'm very grateful.
Of course you are. Now run along. Oh, poor child. I tell you, Fronto, it feels so good knowing that I could do something to help.
Lucia, wait.
Julian, what are you doing out this late at night?
I just went to your father's house. He said, it's not true, is it? You didn't sell yourself to Perpetua. Lucia, tell me it isn't true. But why? Why would you do something like that?
You know, none of us can marry without a dowry.
But there has to be something. Some jewelry left by your mother? Some money your father has hidden away? A goat? Anything?
Nothing. Even if there was enough for us to marry, how can I marry when Constance and Helen are just as much...
But why does it have to be you? Why couldn't one of them sell themselves?
Julian!
I know it sounds wrong, but you have to understand. I know I haven't been free to say it, but...
Don't.
I love you. You know that I love you. I have never loved anybody else.
Stop it, Julian. You're a good man. It's not fair of you to make this any harder for me than it already is.
This is really what you want to do?
This is what I can do. It feels right and good somehow, even though it hurts to lose something that I was hoping for.
Oh, okay. I won't bother you anymore. I hope God brings you great joy in life.
And I you.
I don't know how that'll be anymore. I think I love you now more than I did before. Goodbye, Lucia.
Goodbye, Julian.
Is it done? Did you make the agreement?
You shouldn't have told Julian where I was going.
Well, I have hoped that he would be able to talk you out of it, but I guess not. When do you leave? Tomorrow?
End of the month. She'll have the money by then. I'm tired, Father. Let's turn in.
Was able to get through to Father last night.
Yeah. Oh.
What is it?
Are you mad at me or something?
No. Why?
Someone put coal in my stocking.
Coal? That's weird. Who would do a thing like that?
I don't know, but there's a big cold lump of...
Yeah.
It's not coal. It's money. A lot of money. Enough for...
Father, Lucia!
What is it? What is wrong? Wow, what is this?
I found it this morning when I woke up, in my stocking.
I thought you said Perpetua hadn't paid you yet.
She hasn't.
So, where did this come from? Someone must have, there, through the window, someone must have slipped it through the window last night while we were sleeping, but who would do such a thing?
It was in Constance's stocking, so it must have been meant for her. Maybe it was from Alexander?
So romantic! I wish Felix had money enough to put in my stocking. All I would get is stitch.
Lucia, maybe now you don't have to...
No, I still want to. For Helen. Perhaps now is a good time to tell him.
No, wait. Everyone is so happy now. Why don't we wait a few days until after Constance's wedding?
That's what you think is best. Oh, Constance, I'm so happy for you. You and Felix will be able to marry soon.
Do you really think so?
Yeah. Actually, there's been something I've been meaning to tell you.
And you and Julian too, of course. You two are meant to be, just like me and Felix. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm interrupting you again. What were you about to say?
You know what? Let's talk about it in the morning.
You all right?
Yeah, tired. My feet are so sore. All that dancing.
Here, go to bed then. I'll do the stockings tonight.
Thanks, Helen.
You see Constance off all right?
Oh, yes. She and Alexander are well on their way to Sparta. No, I had to keep reminding myself that she's only moving to the next village, but still, it seems so far away.
Don't worry, Father. You still got me and Lucia.
Yes, for a little while yet, but I think soon it may be your turn.
That's what Lucia said. It's nice to see everyone so optimistic. Good night, Father. Go to bed soon. You know you've been sleeping a lot at the table lately.
Oh, have I?
Thank you.
You know, that certainly was some wedding.
I'll say. Poor Felix. The way Helen dressed him.
Yeah, but he was a pretty good sport about it, you know? He looked really happy and very miserable at the same time.
You too. Happy, I mean. It was good to see.
Yes, I was. Happy for Helen and for Constance, too. I just wish that same kind of happiness for you.
Father, you should know I've spoken with Perpetua. With the change in our family circumstances, I won't be selling myself after all. At least, not yet. There's no hurry now that both my sisters are married, and I thought we could spend a little more time together before things have to change.
Well, how did Perpetua take it?
Fine. I might have mentioned that Sebellius had some new hair pieces in from Rome, so I think she'll be spending her allowance elsewhere this month.
You know, that woman, too much money, too much time.
Do you need help mending your nest?
No, you've done enough taking over your sister's chores. It's getting late. Why don't you turn in?
Fine by me.
Good night, Lucia.
Nicholas?
No, I look ridiculous. Why did I let you dress me up like this?
You're being silly. You look great. Very fashion forward.
Fashion what?
Just get out here. We're gonna be late for the wedding.
There you two are. We're almost ready to start.
What are you wearing?
Don't you just love them? I invented them myself. I call them pants.
I don't like them. They're too restrictive.
I don't know. They definitely have possibilities.
See? I told you. You look adorable.
Well.
Coming, Father?
In just a minute. Nicholas, please, come. I need to have a word with you. You know, that money, that was your inheritance, wasn't it?
It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does. Yes, it does. You know, at first I thought it was Alexander because of his love for Constance. And then I thought perhaps it might have been Sebellius because of his guilt. But you have, why did you do it? You have nothing invested in our family, nothing to gain. Now, if you thought I could repay you, you're sadly mistaken. Not in a million years would I have that kind of money. What will you live on now?
Calm down, Marcus. I didn't throw my inheritance away.
Be serious, Nicholas. I know your parents were rich, but they couldn't have left you much more than what you put into those stockings.
Yes, they did. Look, when my parents died, everyone talked about the good fortune that they had left me. But I didn't care. I just wanted them back. So much so that I became angry with God for taking them away from me. But the sacred writings that my parents raised me on kept coming back to me. They tell a story of a God who holds nothing back, who gives completely. I started reading them again, reading them in a way that I never did before when my parents were still alive. Then it hit me. Maybe God wasn't trying to take something from me. Maybe he was just trying to give.
Give? How do you mean give?
Giving, real giving, means sacrifice. Take Jesus coming to us as a baby. Here is the maker of heaven and earth, allowing himself to learn how to talk, to walk, to have his diaper changed for goodness sake, submitting himself to the parents that he created. Yet he did it all willingly, rejoicing in the sacrifice that would eventually lead him to the cross. The cost is heavy, but the gift, eternal life, is greater still.
But how does taking away your parents, and for that matter, taking away my daughter's dowry, how is that God trying to give us something? I mean, why would he put us through all of that? I mean, I had a plan. It was all worked out. And as a father, I was doing my duty. And then?
Exactly. You had a plan. Marcus was allowing Marcus. What about God's plan? What about Marcus relying on God? Allowing God to provide for your daughters? Coming to him with your concerns instead of trying to tackle it all yourself?
But your parents, my money. I still don't understand.
Marcus, think about it. If I hadn't lost my parents when I did, I wouldn't already have my inheritance, let alone know what to do with it. The money was never really meant for me. Not really. God took something away from me, but only so he could give something important back to you. As far as my parents are concerned, you know, they've been gone for nearly 2 years now. I still miss them, but it's strange. Somehow, I feel closer to them. Maybe because I finally understand what they're trying to teach me. That is, to give me. That is, this is my real inheritance. There's a peace that comes when entering to the sacrificial love that Christ has for us that's far greater than anything we were ever asked to give up. Your daughter, Lucia, understands this, I think.
Yes. Yes, I believe you're right. But what will you do now?
Not sure exactly. Father Clement's leading a pilgrimage to the Holy Land next month. Mm-hmm. I think I might tag along and see what happens. In fact, he's not there yet. There he is.
Oh.
Come on, Marcus. We don't want to be late.
Nicholas. Thank you.
Thank you. brothers and sisters, let me welcome you on this most joyous occasion. We come here today not only to celebrate the union of Julian the farmer and Lucia, daughter of Marcus, but also to call to our hearts and minds the reason for this gift of marriage and to celebrate, break, and to rejoice in the abundant love that we have through Christ for his church. Let us pray.
So you see, Nicholas, when Nicholas gave up his inheritance, the father learned that sometimes doing what's right is not about being fair. It's about doing what's best. Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you?
You're saying there's something better than being a Jedi?
Something a lot better. You see, God is not interested in bringing balance to the Force. He is the Force. And he's one-sided, all good, all the time. Dark side, watch out. Now, I'm not saying that God wanted Michelle to take your lightsaber, but I'm not sure he wanted you to hit her either.
So what you're trying to say is that Jesus is bigger and better than the bad things that happen to us, and if we give him a chance, he'll make something good out of it?
Right on. This Force is strong with this one. You know, it's getting late. We better go to sleep. I know you want to be in bed before St. Nick gets here, right?
St. Nicholas?
Huh?
Nothing. Dad, I'm sorry I hit Michelle.
I know. You can tell her tomorrow yourself.
All right.
Thank you for, I hope you enjoyed that. We
added some lines, forgot a couple lines, had a couple more dramatic pauses than I was anticipating. But I'm really proud of you guys. You did such a good job. They gave up every Saturday since October. They've been here practicing, and I'm just really proud of them. And AV and the stagehands has so many pieces to put together. This has been a really good blessing to me in seeing just how the body of Christ works together and everybody coming together in different parts and creating something new for the glory of God has just been my favorite part. So thank you guys very much. I hope you enjoyed the play. I hope it was entertaining for you. I also hope that it spoke to you and you're able to get something out of it about the humility of Christ and what our lives can look like when we love with the sacrificial kind of love that Christ does. I'd like to invite you to Christmas service. I know it's Christmas morning. I always get really upset when Christmas falls on a Sunday, so I have to give up my Christmas morning. But my husband's preaching this year, so I have to be here.
Slightly different dress.
Yes, but he hopefully will not have the hair. But he has been working very hard to tie his sermon into the themes from this play and really unpack them. So I hope that's intriguing to you. I hope that you come. And, yeah, just thank you guys again so much, and thank you for coming. There's food in the back. So.